it loading?
Oh no, that's probably just my thing. It's a clock. I mean, they got a clock in the wall for the mics.
I got broads in Atlanta. Just at the lean the family. Credit cards in the scammers. Hitting the licks in the banner. Legacies, family. Way and see, look like a panda. Going out like a Montana. Honey killers on the helmets. Legacies.
What's going on, everybody? It's Kai Phoenix, and today we are back again with Connor Nelson for some more pro tips. And today we're going to talk specifically about how he amassed the knowledge that he did, how I've gained the knowledge that I have, even though it's substantially less, and how you could perhaps go forward at any means of level of getting into film and photography, whether that is joining a walk and hike photo club or, you know, doing something, going out as far on a limb as Connor has and enrolling into Columbia University in downtown Chicago, where he's a junior right now. And that's working out pretty good for you. It's a pretty good school, yeah?
Yeah, it's Columbia College, Chicago, and for the price, it's really good.
Right. I had a buddy who did he did some like graphic design there. He liked it a lot. You know, thankful for me and Parks, you know, this whole situation right now in America has got him planted here, which is good because it's allowed us to get a lot of stuff done. And one thing that's been really apparent to me is his knowledge of shit that nobody else knows. Like, there is so much, like, you know, so much you need to know about film and photography, just the basics. But I can see now that in film school, they really take it to the whole next level. And it really makes you look at everything different. Would you agree with that, you know?
Yeah, I mean, you're getting taught by people who are either in the business and they also teach, or you're getting taught by people who used to be in the business. So.
Absolutely. Which is important. You know, qualifications is very important. And I think that in today's era, qualifications get pushed on the wayside, you know, especially with YouTube. For instance, I'm a huge Peter McKinnon fan, right? However, if you ascribe to anybody and everything anybody says, then you're going to be subjected to that. You know, like Peter McKinnon has his recent credentials, you know, but there's still not that guarantee. And so that's what's going to bring me to the next thing I'm talking about, which is investing into your music, you know? I mean, into your art form.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes. Into your film or photography. Now, before we go into that, I just want to talk some brief numbers to what it will take to go to a top film school, okay? And we'll start off with the one he goes to. It's going to be about like $26,000 a year, okay? And that seems steep, but that's on the low side. Because we have UCLA, which is going to be $44,000. That's out of state. But if you're in state, you get it for $14,000. USC is $55,000. New York University is $54,000. And is that that's the New York Film Institute? Is $59,000. $59,000 for a year. Which, that's a lot. That sounds like a lot, you know, any way you cut it, you know. But, once again, like, what is it worth to you? Would you agree that, like, it's actually not that much money, seeing as though what you can get out of it?
It's a lot of money, but at the end of the day, when you come out and you go to a film rental company and you're able to get your hands on these really expensive $100,000 cameras.
Schools like Full Sail, schools, you know, like the Art Institute and other local accredited schools like that are definitely going to offer you some good information too, but it's just not going to be the top tier information. And like I was saying, you could learn this on your own. It's just going to take you a lot longer. But I'm also reaping benefits off of learning on your own because I'm learning purely myself as I'm ready. And the process is taking whatever the process takes, but it ends up taking a lot more of my time because, like, we're shooting, we're editing, we're having meetings, we're trying to plan more stuff, and then on my free time, I'm wandering around in the woods taking pictures. You know, and that's what it's going to take. You know, like, that's what it's going to take if you don't have somebody directly teaching you, you know, that is qualified. You know, so maybe find somebody that is going to film school and good at it, you know, because, shoot, that's pretty cool, film school. But also shoot with people, you know, and most of the stuff I've learned is just from shooting with you, you know.
You got to learn the basics by yourself, yeah, or else you'll never get them.
Yep.
And then you add on, like, the higher end stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Professional.
What I've found through the basics is, like, it's never going to make the same sense to the same two people.
No.
Like, you can explain Aperture or the Triangle to the same people the same way. It's just, it, like, to me, people, so many people explain it to me, and I was like, yeah, I get it, but I don't get it, you know, until you actually do it.
It's like driving a manual car.
Yeah.
Like, you can watch somebody do it a million times and think that you can do it, but right. the first time you the get it, you just can't do it, and you gotta go out and learn it yourself.
800 overexposed pictures.
Yeah, pretty much.
You know, but that's the process too. Be ready to lose, right? Because the good thing about losing in the beginning is you're losing to yourself. You know, don't fake the funk, you know, don't try to be Casey Neistat or Chris Howe and then get up there and then not know how to work your camera. You know, it's the process. And if the process isn't worth it for you, then you could just go to Harvard with everybody else and go to law school and hate your life. Right? So, this was a shorter episode today, and I just wanted to talk to you guys a little bit about education, because education is so important when it comes to this art form. A lot of people think, like, oh, you're an artist. Like, you must just, like, walk around barefoot and finger paint all day. Like, no. Any art has research and knowledge put into it, especially photography, because it has technology that's so old, but the current technology is so new, and they mesh together to get whatever you really want. You know, depending on what you know. And knowledge is truly power. Would you agree with that?
Yeah.
When it comes to cameras and stuff.
Well said.
Absolutely. So the review today, and there'll be a little video coming up here, is gonna be on the Peak Design, and it's like a trigger clamp here that you can put on your belt, on your bag. And I kinda really just started it locks, and I just kinda started using it. And I really like it. I really enjoy it. You know, especially for me when I'm directing, because like I don't want to put my camera down, sometimes I don't want to have it in my hand, but like, you need something you can trust. Like, this is super sturdy. Like, check that out. Super sturdy. It's by Peak Designs. I mean, you can get them at any pro camera store. You can also get them right here for a discounted price if you click on the link to Amazon Associates. So I would just suggest doing that, but only after you've liked and subscribed. That would be great. So, this week we got something really cool coming out. It's the first episode of Get the Shot, which is my new video about the videos that we make. So after we make a music video like Brain Cells we just made, I'll be putting out behind the scenes footage and like a 10-minute video of how we made the video, you know, so you guys can see that. So I'm excited for that, you know, just finished that yesterday. It'll be coming out this week. And, you know, we're just going to be out there getting the shot some more. Thanks to Connor Nelson for being here in a lot of different ways, you know. It's a sacrifice, you know, it's a sacrifice that needs to be made. So, shoot, what do you got to say, Connor? What do you got to say about film school in general? Who should go to film school?
Anybody who's wants to be the best with their...
Yeah, but is that like I like to go fast the best? Or like somebody who really wants to be the best? Because to really want to be the best, you got to know what it takes to be the best. Because everyone wants to be the best. I mean, I want to be LeBron James.
Just go to film school.
Perfect. So, if you want to go to film school or you want to be LeBron James, go to film school. I'm Kai Phoenix. This is Connor Nelson. We'll be back next week with something that will help you out. Please be safe. We'll see you next time. Get the shot. Just get it. Get the shot. I get broads in Atlanta, chasing Dublin and shit, sipping Fanta, credit cards in the-